And while the candidates jockey for a position and try to win over voters, the bipartisan group called No Labels is still hammering away at its goal of bringing the parties together. Today, they announced Republicans Ben Carson, Chris Christie, John Kasich, Rand Paul, and Donald Trump, and one Democrat, Martin O'Malley, have all signed a pledge to work toward the No Labels policy agenda, which calls for creating jobs, securing Social Security and Medicare, balancing the federal budget, and making the United States energy secure. A short time ago, I spoke with the group's co-chairs, former Connecticut Senator Joe Lieberman and former Utah Governor Jon Huntsman. Senator Lieberman, Governor Huntsman, thank you for joining us. So you have five Republicans and one Democrat who've signed this pledge. What exactly are they pledging to do, Governor Huntsman?
Well, they're pledging to embrace a process for goal setting and leadership in a bipartisan fashion, drawing from the elements of a national strategic agenda, which include four big policy categories, jobs, entitlements, energy, and a balanced budget. And essentially, every one of the six candidates, a very diverse group, I might add, they are stating that they'll support the national strategic agenda. And number two, they'll sit down and meet with a bipartisan group of congressional leaders within 30 days of being elected to the presidency. And third, to establish a goal of drawing from one of those big issue categories and leading out in a bipartisan fashion in delivering what the American people really are looking for.
Well, Senator Lieberman, hearing this, aren't these, though, the kind of general goals stated in a broad brush way that just about anyone could agree to?
Well, that's exactly the way we framed them, because we're operating from the premise that we're trying to disrupt the dysfunction in the Washington political system. We're trying to create some incentives for people to work together. And one of the best ways is to have people agree at least on commonly held goals. That's the four policy areas. So really, left, right, center, Democrat, Republican, should agree on the goals. And then for these presidential candidates to promise, if they get elected, that within the first 30 days in office, they'll call members of Congress, both parties, in to begin negotiating to get something done on at least one of the goals. Frankly, I'm surprised that all 15 of the current presidential candidates didn't sign on to this. I'm grateful that the six did, but I'm puzzled that the other nine haven't. And we're going to continue to pursue them to make our case that it's not asking much for them to pledge, promise, to work together across party lines, which hasn't happened very much in Washington lately.
Governor Huntsman, though, at the same time, isn't it the fact that candidates from different parties, say a conservative Republican, is going to have a very different concept of what it means to secure Social Security and Medicare than is a liberal Democrat?
And that, Judy, is the beauty of governing. And that's why this process is so important. It's what I had to do as governor of a state. You create a vision, you put forward ideas, you build bipartisan coalitions, and you manage it through to fruition. It's been a long time since we put points on the board in terms of getting big, important things done for the American people. I can remember in the 80s when Ronald Reagan did so with Speaker Tip O'Neill, they set a goal around Medicare, Social Security, and tax reform. And I remember in the 90s when Bill Clinton and Newt Gingrich, then Speaker of the House, they too set a goal, differing widely from an ideological standpoint. They took two respectively different pathways to the end point, but you know what? They got there. So you've got to set the goal first and expect that people on both sides are going to negotiate, compromise, and ultimately figure out a way to get there. That's all part of the process.
But, Senator Lieberman, you're not underestimating how far apart these candidates, many of them, are on these fundamental questions.
In a sense, we are, through No Labels, in a very different way, expressing the anger, the frustration that so many Americans feel about how the American government has gone off the track. And it's being expressed by a lot of these candidates with anger as well. But in the end, you got to be more than angry. You got to be willing, history tells us, to work with people in the other party to get something done. And we're trying to create a vehicle for the voters to send that message loud and clear to the presidential candidates.
And Governor Huntsman, finally, though, can you really hold these candidates accountable?
The American people will do just that, I have no doubt. The country is hungry for this kind of sense of bipartisan problem solving. They're turning out, and you better believe they're turning out to the town hall meetings and will be right up until the primary. And they're going to hold the candidates accountable ultimately. And that's why creating the vehicle, which we have done through no labels, is exactly what needs to be done. There's no other movement quite like it. We're Republicans, we're Democrats, we're independents. We all have different affiliations, but we all agree on the necessity of problem solving in order to get the work of the American people done. And that's what's been missing.
Governor Jon Huntsman, Senator Joe Lieberman, we thank you both.